Hello, I'm Dr. Miles Bateman. I'm here to talk a little bit about vintage baseball. I started playing vintage baseball about 4 years ago. I went to a St. Louis Cardinals winter warm-up, and I read some information on a team called the St. Louis Perfectos. So I contacted the Perfectos, and they put me in contact with a good friend of mine who lives in Florissant, Missouri, and his name's Brian, and he's the captain of a team called the St. Louis Unions. Well, I had the opportunity to play with the Unions for their initial season, their inaugural season, and it helped us with launching our local team, the Trenton Maines, here in Trenton, Illinois. So I thought I'd give you just some of the basics of the game, some of the things that we enjoy about going out playing with playing ball against one another, playing in different cities and different venues, and just some kind of some rules of the game and some things, some do's and some don't do's. Basically, the idea of vintage baseball is to try to play baseball like it was meant to be played when it was first invented, and that date goes back to the 1830s, 1840s, kind of predating the Abner Doubleday myth that's kind of been propagated throughout the United States. A lot of people credit the invention of baseball to men who were around long before Abner Doubleday. In fact, there's an archaeological find that said that baseball was played in New England as early as the 1780s. So baseball goes back a long time in America, predating Abner Doubleday. But we try to recreate the game as it was played from the 1860s to the 1890s, and that means we play ball with no gloves. So we play baseball with no gloves. The baseball we use is roughly the same size as regular baseball, a little bit larger, but it stings just as bad when it hits you in the hand. And I'm telling you, I've had some days where I left the field with blisters on my hands or, calluses that got torn off, and it was kind of a painful experience. But it's a lot of fun to get out there and play against the guys, and we had a chance to play not only with some of the local teams, but also when the Baseball is America exhibit from Cooperstown was in St. Louis a couple years ago. We got to play against some teams from all around the nation. Now, a couple of things I've got to show you here are one of the baseball caps that we use. This is an old-time baseball cap, just like you see in the old Judge cigarette baseball cards. We wear these. We collect buttons, and this is a kind of the light's going to glare off of it, but that's a Trenton Maines anniversary button that we wear on the back of our helmets. We also use bigger bats, and they're a little bit bigger than regulation. Not much. Here's a bat I've made. It's probably one of the biggest ones in the league as far as like thickness and length. In fact, it goes right to the max. I've engraved my name, Miles Moonlight Bateman, on the side of it here, so people don't pick it up and think it's theirs and walk off with it. And it's one of the things that's kind of a trademark of our game. Now, nicknames is another big part of it. Miles Moonlight Bateman. Moonlight is my vintage baseball nickname, and I take that from Doc Graham from the movie Field of Dreams. And if you remember that movie, Doc Graham was like one of the preeminent characters in there, and he just loved the game. The jersey I'm wearing is a vintage baseball jersey. It laces up the front. It has a large space so you can move around in it. The arms are pretty free-flowing. They had collars when they first came out. And we have a large red letter T to annotate that we play for the Trenton Maines. One of the things I'm wondering that you would get fined for if you were caught wearing a game is a wristwatch, a digital wristwatch. You can't wear those in vintage baseball because it takes away from the authenticity and the originality of the game. We try to get back to the way the game was originally played, and they didn't have timepieces they wore on their arms back then. Some people had stopwatches, and our timekeepers and our umpires are allowed to keep those, but they're the only ones. There's no cussing, no spitting, no scratching, no touching yourself inappropriately. Nothing that's allowed in Major League Baseball these days. We don't play under the lights. We play in open fields. Occasionally we'll play on Major League or on Minor League Baseball fields, kind of in a celebratory mode or to commemorate the founding of a team. Or we play in some minor league ballparks, like with the Gateway Grizzlies, on their way back Tuesdays or their throwback Thursdays. So we do play in games like that, and we have played in some professional baseball parks before, and it's a lot of fun when we get to do that. And we've played up in Danville, Illinois, with the Danville Dams before, and one of our affiliate teams, the St. Louis Red Stockings, playing Cincinnati with the Cincinnati Reds every year on opening day. So vintage baseball has kind of been sweeping the nation. It's teams are forming all the time. The Old Town Next to ours is just forming a team this year, and we've kind of fostered about five or six teams in Illinois, Southern Illinois, starting up in the last couple of years. And we're just excited about the opportunity to get out and play more, teach more people about the game, especially kids, getting them involved with vintage baseball. And we're excited about the opportunities that we have ahead of us. And if you'd like more information, please visit our website, which is TrentonMains.org or VBBA.org or Vintage Baseball Association keyword Google search. And you can find out more about the great game of baseball. So with that, I will leave you with something we always say at the end of the game when we're about ready to run on the field, and that's this: for the glory of the game, this is Dr. Miles Moonlight Bateman signing off.